Always one of the most eagerly awaited video games finally goes on sale.
Preparing to rewrite retail history.
A video game is expected to have bigger first day revenues than any movie has ever had an opening day at the box office.
Biggest retail launch in entertainment
history.
You know,
dozens of grown men and probably about three women have crawled out of their parents' basements tonight to be first in line to buy the new video game, Halo 2.
Video gamers across the country are anxiously awaiting the midnight release of a game called Halo 2.
45 minutes and counting for Halo 2 to go
on. Halo 2 had just launched with some insane hype to it. It had sold 2.4 million copies in its first 24 hours and laid a foundation for all multiplayer games to come with its matchmaking system. I excitedly booted up the game, ready to experience the hype firsthand. The graphics were like nothing I had ever seen before, and what's best is I could even share it with my little brother. We didn't have an internet connection at the time, but my brother and I didn't really care. We just booted up custom games and played against each other 1v1. There was just one little problem. I was 5, and Halo 2 was the first game I had ever played. I had to play the campaign with the TV muted to protect my wee little ears. This didn't deter me though, dragging my, at the time, 3-year-old brother to play some split screen with me so he could practice to play against the teenagers in our youth group. Every Sunday night they would use the church projector and hook up a bunch of Xboxes so we could have LAN parties playing Big Team Coagulation. Having no access to the internet didn't stop me from becoming a little monster, as my entire life revolved around 1v1ing my brother on the daily. I distinctly remember teaching people 3 times my age how sword lunging worked, and still topping the leaderboards at our little matches. I was happy. Not long after we picked up the game, my parents had bought something called the Multiplayer Map Pack, and oh boy did this totally change how me and my brother played. While other kids spent their days playing with toys outside, me and my brother spent our time role-playing in various Halo 2 maps. Guarding our bases and containments, breaking each other out of maps by ramming each other with the Wraith, excitedly reading the little booklet that came with the game, and breaking each other's noses while pretending to do the melee attacks from the game on each other. We never grew up with much money, and we had to appreciate the games we had. But after my 3rd time breaking my brother's nose, my parents said enough was enough and banned us from the game. Heartbroken, me and my brother were now doomed to a normal childhood. When we lost access to Halo, me and my brother just decided to play outside. We moved nearly every year, and while my brother was able to cope with it pretty well, I was not. I've never been very good at making new friends, and I had a lot of social anxiety. I drowned my sorrows away playing Pokemon Soul Silver and creating awful flip notes, but when I finally turned 13, I said enough was enough. I went to my parents and begged for them to let us play Halo 2 again. We craved the warm beaches of Zanzibar, the tight quarters of Foundation, the chill of containment. And after a good 15 minutes of begging, our parents finally allowed us to play it. We just got right back onto our horse. But this time we could experience the campaign in its full, unmuted glory. We never understood the plight of the Arbiter in the past, the corruption that ran deep within the Covenant, the genuine sadness the Arbiter felt after being betrayed by his own leaders, the motherfucking Gravemind! All of it was burned into our little heads, and we loved every moment of it. Halo 2 was incredibly important to me, not just because it was my first Halo game, not just because of its phenomenal writing, but because of my entire early childhood was engulfed by it. The game cemented itself as my favorite Halo game of all time, even when Halo 3 released and we finally got access to the internet on our Xbox 360. I still found myself longing for Halo 2, and so did my brother. There were days where we'd hop off of Halo 3 to instead play Halo 2 just as we always had, because it reminded us of what we once had. I never knew the development hell that went behind the scenes of this game, its online community, nor why the game was so revolutionary to others. None of that really mattered to me at the time. Halo 2 is important to me because it reminds me of a simpler time when we didn't have to worry about a thing, and my best friend was my brother.
When you first saw Halo, were you blinded by its majesty?
Well, of course I was. Who wasn't? Here's some highlights from me and my buddies playing Halo 2.
Oh! I can see your sword!
Do you like my sword?
Your sword is still very visible.
goddamn.
It's kind of funny, honestly.
Alright, I'm back by the nut.
I'm behind you.
Okay.
Battle. This is just gonna be battle for the coconut.
But get behind the barricades. Where's that coming from?
Eat shit.
Oh, you got her. Okay. Okay, you move the coconut. I'll look out for Kelly.
Up on top. That coconut.
She's coming on top. Look out, nades.
I'm willing to sacrifice everything for that coconut.
It just captured a flag, but with a coconut.
What? How did that not kill you? What the?
Oh no, she has the coconut. We must defend.
Get it back.
Okay, I have a good idea where I am.
I don't, but I see our bodies. So oh, there she is! Got her. What? Where's the nut?
Coconut. Coconut.
Keep moving it, I'll keep a lookout. Oh, look, here she comes! I'm dead!
Oh no,
no she's got the nut! Hopefully it falls back down the ramp. Good luck, Kelly. Nobody can get that thing up a ramp.
But it keeps hopping up. Alright. You know what? I'm throwing it in the ocean.
No!
Away with this coconut nonsense, I say.
Eat shit.
You know,
thank you.
I don't know how I missed both of those lunches.
I'll keep a lookout on this end.
Alright, I got it up the ramp! I got it in the room, I'm gonna put it in this corner and then we'll be okay, we just gotta defend it in this corner.
I'm the brood mother of the coconut.
Nut mother.
Why is that the word that you use?
There she is, she's invisible, but I can see her sword!
No!
God damn it! It's the nut. This is like some weird game of capture the flag where you gotta move the flag from the corner into the ocean.
It's like physics-based oddball.
Okay, the coconut's still here.
Thank God.
Oh God! Scared the hell out of me.
The coconut. No, the coconut. Go defend the coconut.
I'm going as fast as I can.
Captured a nut.
As you command, Nut Mother.
The Nut Mother grows suspicious.
Ooh, now I have two coconuts.
Here she comes. Here she comes. Here she comes. Here she comes.
I hear
I have two coconuts over here.
That's fine. We have the best one over here.
I have the sacred nut.
I'm taking it.
I have the sacred nut. Here she comes. Through the door!
I know.
Then run!
No, I was gonna try. It didn't work. My surprise. How do you kill both of us? What the fuck? You're much closer than I am, such as it is.
Oh,
thank goodness.
When I was recording this footage, something dawned on me. I was having even more fun playing with my friends online now than I ever had in the past. Even now, almost 20 years after the game has launched, it still brings me so much joy to play it. I'd just like to take a moment to thank you for listening to me ramble on about this game. I hope you boot up a custom game just to explore and truly take in those multiplayer maps with your best buds. I'd love to hear some of the memories that you got watching this video in the comments below. I hope your day treats you with kindness and be excellent to each other. Peace!